Don't throw away old batteries. With the right restoration methods, they can be brought back to life and reused, saving money and reducing waste. The video provides a simple yet effective method for restoring old lead-acid batteries that have lost their ability to hold a charge using bleach javel. The content mainly focuses on the chemical principle behind this method, where javel helps dissolve lead sulfate build up on the battery plates, thereby improving conductivity and restoring battery performance. First, the video may demonstrate how to check a faulty battery using a voltmeter to determine the extent of degradation. Next, it details the process of opening the battery caps, draining the old electrolyte, and cleaning the battery with water and javel to remove sulfate deposits. The video also emphasizes the importance of refilling the battery with new electrolyte or adding distilled water properly to ensure stable operation. Additionally, the video may verify the effectiveness of this method by measuring the voltage after restoration and comparing the battery's performance before and after treatment. It may also provide safety precautions when handling chemicals. Along with the limitations of this approach, it only works on batteries that are not severely damaged. In summary, this is an affordable and easy-to-follow method for reviving old batteries, making it a great alternative to buying a new one. However, its long-term effectiveness depends on the battery's condition before restoration. Here, we can see a total of 6 acid and lead cells inside the battery. The chemical principle behind this method is based on the reaction between javel sodium hypochlorite, NaCl, and lead sulfate PbSO, which accumulates on the battery plates over time. In a degraded lead-acid battery, PbSO forms as a byproduct of the discharge process and can crystallize, reducing the battery's ability to store and deliver power. When javel is introduced, its strong oxidizing properties help break down and dissolve these lead sulfate deposits, effectively restoring the battery plate's conductivity. Use a syringe to extract the javel solution and inject it into each of the battery's cells, then shake the battery gently to distribute the solution evenly. This process improves electron flow within the battery, allowing it to hold a charge more effectively. However, the reaction should be carefully controlled, as excessive exposure to strong oxidizers can potentially damage the internal components of the battery. Please note that this process should be carried out in a well-ventilated area with a fan to help disperse the acid fumes. The chemical reaction inside the battery produces toxic gases that can be irritating and harmful if inhaled. Always prioritize safety when handling chemicals. I'll try sealing these to rubber caps to see what happens. This will help determine whether the reaction inside the battery is affected by sealing the cells, such as changes in pressure, gas buildup, or the efficiency of the cleaning process. Let it soak for about 10 minutes before proceeding to the next steps. Make sure to follow the exact procedure shown in the video for the best results. Insert a wooden stick into the battery cells to help the solution drain out more efficiently. This ensures that the cleaning process is more effective and that any remaining residue is properly removed. The cleaning process inside the battery takes some time, so it's important to remove as much of the old solution as possible. This ensures that the new electrolyte added later will be more effective, helping the battery regain its performance. Be patient and thorough for the best results. The result shows that the sulfate deposits have been removed and expelled from the battery. This helps restore the conductivity of the plates, improving the battery's ability to hold and deliver charge more effectively. The next step is to rinse the inside of the battery with clean water. This will help flush out any remaining sulfate deposits and chemical residues. Repeat the process twice to ensure the battery is thoroughly cleaned before adding the new electrolyte. I will use a new acid solution and fill it into each of the battery cells. This step is crucial for restoring the battery's ability to store and deliver electrical energy efficiently. Make sure to pour the acid carefully to avoid spills and follow safety precautions. During this process, I will connect a multimeter to measure the voltage and check the battery's performance. This will help determine whether the restoration was successful and if the battery is holding a proper charge. Now, I will use another battery with the same voltage but a higher current to boost the voltage of the restored battery. This process, often called jump-starting or charging, helps activate the chemical reactions inside the battery, improving its ability to hold and deliver charge effectively. After that, I will charge the battery using a specialized charger. This step ensures that the battery is fully recharged and stabilized, helping to maximize its performance and longevity. The voltage increased significantly. This indicates that the battery is responding well to the restoration process and is capable of delivering a higher current output. However, this should be done with caution to avoid sparks or damage to the battery. This specialized charger has a charging current of 5 W, which provides a steady and controlled charge to the battery. This helps ensure a safe and efficient recharge, preventing overcharging and extending the battery's lifespan. And now my restored battery is fully charged. We will measure the voltage again and test its performance to see if the restoration process was successful. This final check ensures that the battery can hold a charge properly and deliver sufficient power for practical use. I will test the voltage using the homemade welding machines. This DIY welder was introduced in my previous video. After watching this video, please visit my channel to see how I built these welding tools myself. I have successfully restored this battery. It is now fully charged and functional, ready for use. This proves that with the right method, an old battery can be brought back to life instead of being discarded. If you found this video helpful and interesting, please leave a like and subscribe to support my channel. Your support gives me more motivation to create new videos. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.